Now today we are going to discuss about the HTML table part. Now since most of you have left the question in the second test one, so I am giving again the same question in the second test two. So let's learn about it. So now here is the table, and if you want to design this table in HTML, then how will you design? Now first of all, you have to see how many rows are there. So this one will be one row. Then if you see here, you can take it as this one is the second row and this one is the third row. Now for the first row here, as you can see, three columns are combined. So we have to use the cross pen to join these three columns. So first tag will be the table. Then this first row. In the first row, there is only one data, that is student. So since there is only one data, student, so only one TD will be there. With TD, there is a combination of three columns. So we will use cross pen. Which will join how many columns? How many columns is three? So we write three. Then the data is subject. Then the TD goes, and at last TR goes. Now for the second row, see, as you can see here, two rows are combined to write C. So we will use the second row, that is TR. Then the first data is C. So first data is C, but we are using what? Row span here. So we will write here row span. How many rows are combined? Rows are two. So we will write here two. Then the data is C. So C and data close. Then this one is over. Then in the second row, D is there. So we will use the second data, TD. Then D is there. Then TD close. Now as we move on forward, here A is there. Now again here in A, we are using the joining two rows. So we will again have to use the row span. So we will again write TD. Then under TD we will write row span. Then is equal to 2. Then what is the data? A. So we will write A. Then TD close. Now since the second row is also over, then since it is open here, so we will close it here. Now for the third row, in the third row C already we have used, then A already we have used, only remain this B. So we will write only B for the third row, that is TD. Since B gone, C gone, so B will be there. So TD, table data, since no row span or column span is there, so we will just close it and write B, and then closing TD, then at last table row, no row. Now table started here, so we will enter table. So now the whole table is completed. Now since you want a border of this table, so we will have to use the border attribute, that is border. B-O-R-D-E-R is equal to of any size, suppose 2. And if you want to give the background or anything, we will have to write inside the any tag. So that's all for today. Thank you.